How's it going, everyone? So a couple of days ago, I noticed on the mandarin tree that is behind me, I noticed that it was showing some signs of an iron deficiency. So I just wanted to make a bit of a video just to show you guys how to spot and how to tell the signs of an iron deficiency when a tree or a plant that you have is going through that. So yeah, so you know what it looks like, what to look out for, and then also a few ways on how to treat the iron deficiency. So first I'll show you the mandarin tree and show you the leaves and how to tell, and then later on in the video I'll be discussing a few different ways on how you can treat it. So here we are, guys, at the mandarin tree I was talking about. And so I was just noticing as I was picking a few mandarins a couple of days ago, because they're getting quite sweet now, that a few of these leaves, as you can see, they're yellowing. These are the young leaves, as you can see at the tips, and they are yellowing but also got green veins, and so you can see these with a lot of the plants, yeah, that they're just starting to show, and that is the sign of iron deficiency, that it has these green veins which you can see there, and then in between them they've got that yellowing. And the key to this is that they are in the young leaves. As you can see, this is a shoot here, and right by the tip, you know, the tip's right there where that little flower is, and some of those new leaves, they're starting to go yellow. If it wasn't, then it would be a magnesium deficiency if they were in the older leaves, but as you can see right back in the older leaves, there's none of that. They're all green, and it's only in these tips that are starting to show signs of an iron deficiency. So now to how to treat your iron deficiency. So really the best way and easiest way to treat your iron deficiency is to get something like chelated iron or granulated iron. Now this, just like this, so this is chelated iron, and it is very water soluble, so you just you mix it with water. Generally it's for every 10 litres, so for this one I recommended 10 scoops because it comes with a little scoop. Recommended 10 scoops for 10 litres. You mix that in, very easily dissolves in water, and then you apply that around the base of the plant, so water in where the roots, and it takes it up. This is generally fairly quickly, generally happens within a few days. You'll start to be, or should start to be, seeing the iron deficiency correct itself. Then otherwise, another way you can apply this granulated or chelated iron is through a foliar spray. So you mix it up. I don't really think you need to have it as strong, but you mix it up in a spray bottle or however you're going to apply it, and in the afternoon, late afternoon is best because this is when the stomata in the leaves, they start to open to let in carbon dioxide. This way it'll also uptake the water vapor with the iron in it, and this works much faster. This is generally, I think, within around a day or so, you should really start to see it correct itself. Now, the second reason your plant could be suffering from an iron deficiency is from the pH. So iron is an element that needs to be in a more acidic soil to become readily available to plants to uptake from the soil. So if your soil is too basic or too alkaline, meaning, you know, it's sort of above 7, the iron, you'll find that the iron becomes locked up in the soil and the plants can't take it up. There can be heaps of iron in the soil, there can be plenty of iron in the soil, but the pH, because it's too high, has locked it up. So what you want to do is lower the pH. Now in a moment I will mention two ways you can do this, but you really find this sort of locked up effect, so to speak, in acid-loving plants like blueberries. Now my blueberries, they're quite young and they're in a good soil blend, acidic soil blend, so they aren't showing signs of this yet, but in the future they might. Iron becomes best uptakeable from, I think it's like 1, right up until about 7, I think. Then it really drops off and really becomes locked up in the soil. So really the best ways to do this, to fix this, is get a pH soil kit, which you can really buy quite easily from nurseries and other stores that that have sort of garden sections in them. Use that as recommended and check to see where your soil pH is at. If it's really above 7 or maybe even 6.5 should be fine, but if it's starting to get 7 or above, you might want to correct it. So basically all you need to do is add agricultural sulfur or elemental sulfur as recommended by whatever brand it is. And basically what this does is that over time it slowly acidifies the soil, and this is a better long-term effect. As it sort of just works through the soil and microbes break it down, it acidifies the soil. So it means it drops the pH of the soil, which means that the iron doesn't become locked up, and it can be uptaken from the plant. Otherwise, another way to fix this, and this is more of a short-term solution, is to add something like sphagnum moss. So sphagnum moss is very acidic. It's generally around 3.5, I think, in pH. And so if you add that to the soil, you can add it as a mulch or slightly dig it in or something like that. That will lower the pH of the soil, and so the iron then becomes free for the plants to uptake. However, this generally is more of a short-term solution, and so really it would be best to add something like the sulfur to your soil to fix your iron deficiency. So there you go, guys. I hope that helped you a bit in identifying and treating iron deficiency in your plants. So I'll be watching this citrus tree, and over the next couple of days and over the next week, just to see for any improvements, and if not, might just have to give it just a real little extra bit. Otherwise, yeah, like I said, pH test, I haven't done that yet, so that will also be an option, which I'll probably actually do first before I apply any more iron, if it doesn't look like the tree is getting any better. So before I move on, I do have to say a big thank you to my patrons. They're the financial supporters of my channel, so thank you guys so much. I know I haven't been posting as many videos on Patreon as I would have liked to. Just really haven't had the time, and there's just a few other reasons as well. But I should be able to do some more, so thank you guys for your patience, and thank you for all your contributions to my channel. So if you like that video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. And if you have any comments, suggestions, or questions for me, pop them down below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Or if you just want to say g'day, you can just say g'day, and I'll just see how you guys are doing. And finally, if you haven't subscribed, make sure you click on my face. That'll be popping up around here somewhere. That way you'll just stay notified whenever I post a new video here on YouTube. You can come along and suss out what I'm talking about. That's it, guys. So thank you for watching, if you stuck around to the end, and I will catch you all next video. Cheers all.